Let's notice it's coming with a fast undercarriage. Reducing drag at high speed as our aircraft do travel faster, burning less fuel and therefore more operational endurance on tank. Broadway, actually, how big that aircraft is. Just under 23 metres long. The main rotor, 18.5 metres wide. And the tail rotor, 4 metres across. And all of the Merlin upgrade work that you were talking about is far from over, because Project Crow's Nest is very much in the throes of early development, isn't it? It is, so we're very lucky enough to have a CTA sat, which is over at the Sunny Park again, and particularly one of the few main things that we're trying to do. We have a very good break up, which is on one side, in a place called Bag, and the name Baggers, so we give to them. The Crow's Nest project is going to take that station to a radar, upgrade it, and attach it to a Merlin. So that's in progress from this. You'll see Merlin developing with the radar underneath the telescope out doing the job of seeking, you can see, and still doesn't matter. Final pass. Do you want to have wavy stations? Do they go fast, please? So everyone, give your appreciation for the Merlin Mark II of 84 Naval Air Squadron, Sol Rose, and the Merlin Helicopter 4.
Thank you.
9G currently operating Edinburgh trainers. The aircraft leased from Griffin International. The 12-year agreement for the lease of the aircraft was signed in 2014. And this is bringing new capabilities still to the Griffin. A very capable little aeroplane being driven there, greatest in the long line of Saab fighters, Saab jet fighters that began soon after World War II. But this is the first one that's really achieved great success on the export market. The Draken had a little, but the Griffin rather more, sold to a wide variety of nations other than Sweden, its home country, alongside the Czech Republic, Brazil, Hungary, South Africa and Thailand, all current operators.